Alrighty, I'm back. Yeah, apparently, I have to go with a payment from somebody. It's a weird thing sometimes. So, obviously the weird part about an online business, you end up having to accept payments in all kinds of random ways at times. Like, of all of them, MoneyGram has always made the least sense to me. Like, okay, you have an account number, you have a bank. You go, you do the payment, and it's there now. And you have a receipt for it. A number and everything. And then I get people that come up and they're like, no, I have to MoneyGram it. Like an $11 to occasionally like $20 fee. I'm like, no, I have to do it this way, because then I'll know it's there and I'll have a confirmation number in, you know, in case something goes haywire. Like, okay. So, apparently, a receipt from the bank with the account number on there is not going to be sufficient, but a also still not exactly full backable MoneyGram thing that costs some money and basically causes somebody to have to go all the way across town to go pick it up. That's better somehow. Like, it ends up taking more effort and resources on both sides. Whatever. Things happen. And I know everybody's got their reasons. 100 different reasons why somebody would need to do that, but by and large, I probably should not have done that. Hello. Just let me get away from the borderline, buddy. I know, you've got overboost and you're so proud of it. Just gonna use it all day. Where overboosting tanks just annoy the hell out of me in this game. But it's not even like, it's absolutely their main strategy, that's, you know, that's absolutely fair. It is what it is. I just mean, in general principle, it's just kind of annoying. You're trying to get away. It's like, no, you weigh like a billion pounds, stop coming at me like an oncoming train. So, anyway. It is what it is. Yeah, retry. That was a crap attempt. But, I mean, I say, in general, it's this guy. It is only this guy. Everyone else is whatever. They at least have some reason for it. Like the one that overboosts with a gigantic shotgun on her back. Yeah, that's awesome. That I absolutely get and understand. That's awesome. I like their build and their hard fight, but whatever. In this one, it's usually because it's only in the double battle where it's an issue. And it's like, no, I want to get away from your gun and your howitzer. Please stop infinitely coming at me. And basically, they don't have to expend the energy to move around. They just have to keep boosting and boosting and boosting, and that's it. So overall, their movement ends up more efficient, I think. Oh, what a shame. It takes you forever to turn around. This is kind of my go-to strategy if ever charging here. I mean, and granted, there's very little reason to be charging all the time, but what can I say? It's a start, I see. So far, charging has not actually punished me as much as I would have thought it would. Yeah, I think it's partially because this guy's got the really sucky machine gun. It's kind of frustrating. Like, you know, you've got the worst gun possible, and you're still repeatedly getting all the hits in and whatnot. And the boost kicking was a thing in 3. I would have been so dead right there. Thankfully not the case. Alright, so how can I make your day today? That seems fair. Get a bunch of close range guys, bring in the shoddy. I like Trafalgar. It's funny to me how the crappier one is usually at the head here. Oh man, that is a good combo right there. You'll never repeat it, but that's a good combo. Nice, even got his parry blade off. It actually parried a blade. Like some sort of miracle's going on. There you go. Good job overheating. I say, while roasting? Interesting idea also for, interesting idea also for, like, random remake challenges and whatnot. Just have the AC function like it has a fuse box, like it overheats, and it just shuts down some random part. You gotta reset the entire thing. Oh man, that's unfortunate timing. Alright. Faster. Man, you guys really be taking advantage of this opportunity right now. But you're not. That's adorable. Like, where are the close range ACs? Check out our mid range. Good job. Man, you're fucking rules. Like, when he works, he really works. And as far as partners go, the tankiness plus his tendency to stay at a pretty reasonable range, plus the random shotgun bomb rushes, it's good stuff. Who's next? Barketta. Mm-hmm. What the hell are we fighting again? The heat guys. Okay. Yeah, so balance-wise, gotta wonder that rifle with the huge friggin' hitbox. Gotta wonder, was it just something to be newbie friendly, or was that actually intended to be balanced? And I think right now it's currently lagging because of the uploads going on. Because after checking all the stuff going on, that's about all that's happening. Nothing's running the scan, nothing's doing anything. I just want to finish this in the next hour. And, I'll be done with it for the moment. Gonna be taking a little hiatus. had done that crossback one a good bit of the way, and then I accidentally overrode it, so I'll redo that. Daughter, how about... Oh, well, let's save you. Yeah, actually, one thing that I'd like to do a video of that I have no means of doing at the moment because it doesn't want to run is a game called Drainstorm. It's an old, potentially roguelike... like tile base. Well, it is basically a roguelike, and it's a roguelike where you play as a tank, pretty much. But I don't think they figured out the whole autosave thing, so they just had it off basic save files. I mean, the thing looks like a mod of Minesweeper, and I'm pretty sure it is. Right, see me later. You gotta chill. Nothing that intense going on right now. Valkyrie. Okey-doke. Ghetto Brothers next. These two dodge missiles pretty well, but maybe I'll get lucky. They will go and gang up on him. Okay, fine, whatever. As long as Clayson's distracted, I can take this guy. Well, as long as I'm not getting stunned repeatedly. Need more range. So that's it. Fine. All right, the grenade couple. And who am I getting? Yellow boat, why not? Yellow boat's the true hero of AC3. Get to the generators first, don't ask how. Alright, so now, usual problem with these two. This one's not as threatening. Arquette is pulling his best Motherwell impression off in the background. Here's hoping Yellow Boat can pull some magic out of this one. And the nice thing is, she stays on the ground most of the time, so... easy effects blowing up the emulator. Here. Got some animals rustling around my desk. We came here to rustle. Got it. That's the joke. You paid nothing. Don't be too disappointed. Alright, the spaz lady's next. Femme fatales, or whatever you want to call these two. Yeah, why not Joker? He seems like a possible misogynist, I don't know. I think anyone's particularly worried about those sorts of problems in the dystopian future. Nico, have you gotten food? No, I haven't gone and blown up my neighbors, so I haven't gotten anything. It makes you wonder. Like, they shut down an entire sector for no particular reason. But did the controller force, like, a bunch of weird, like, totalitarian, like, raids on stuff for no reason? Something to consider. The guy's just trying to run his ice cream shop. Yep. We've been determined to, harbor friggin' robots in here. 20 square foot friggin' ice cream shop. Where exactly am I gonna fit them? Nope. You've been designated to be nuked. Sorry. It says on the paper. Gotta do what the clipboard says. This seems like it would be weirdly effective. To redo this going after the tank, but you know what? It might be easier on target than we can both team on the other guy. Overheat him. Yeah, it's confusing his AI quite a bit. At the very least, it can only whittle him down enough that I can take on the other guy alone. See if he'll survive in this one. Wow. That unlikely combination, though. I know for a fact that you don't do that often. Even if that is what you're supposed to be doing. Jack anymore, actually. Bad time to run out. It's still theoretically possible. Becoming less so by the second. Turn and look. Tank on the opposite end, fire at this guy. Almost out. Let's stop landing straight on top of these attacks. Nope. Really gotta bait out the vertical. Thank you. done with less getting hit by a parry blade. Not overheating the ever-loving crap out of this guy. You're heating it? No? Okay, cool. Down the toughest tank in the three. He's a harder one in SL, but three he takes the cake for sure. I think he might actually have max AP. No, he has almost max AP. Leave my friend alone. It's over. Yeah, I never realized how good Cool Head actually was in this fight. He's not very useful in a lot of them because of the way that he runs around. But in this one, his kind of spazziness, it's perfect. Seven more fights. Fixer. Yeah, why not? Okay. Fixer and Faust, although, again, I've never really seen Faust as a gatekeeper. Or much of a professional-seeming team or whatever. And he's just... grenade spams. That's his thing. Who do I lock onto? Fire at somebody. I don't know why Paranoia is being so useful right now. Yeah, Faust would be a lot better if he had decoys. Like his little like bouncing and hovering thing, it's very difficult to keep track of him with any kind of hand-based weapon. But a missile has no trouble whatsoever. Like if he had decoys, he would be a lot more challenging. And maybe give him a rifle and decoys instead of his bazooka. Alright. Festival of the Dickholes. Let's get Kaiser in on this one. Nice slow-mo. just went through the terrain. Oh, and by the way, one thing. The description. Her description specifically. It says that she's supposed to be good for a variety of situations. How, exactly? She's entirely energy-based. She doesn't really have, like, multiple means for dealing with different things. Like, the pods are good against stationary stuff. The rifle is... Like, while it's okay against other stuff, it's also kind of her main weapon, so it can be the only thing against everything. Like, the pods are specifically, situationally useful, and her rifle is generally useful, but doesn't have much ammunition to it. And other than that, you just have a blade, not even the inside parts. So, like, having used her build before for run once, she's not particularly good for a lot of situations. Yes, I'm gonna be facing snipers. How? I don't know, but let's... How drained is he? Not in the least. Alright, so he made pretty short work of Kaiser then. Sometimes you can outrun the chain gun. Because then if you just do a full boost with anything but the starting booster or at least a lighter build, you can actually just evade it. Alright. Alright, that's worked a couple times before, but... doing? I don't need help with her. Maybe he needs help, my help with that guy. Alright. As long as I'm not targeted, this will work. Kaiser, save my anus. It is being roasted. Kaiser. Buddy. Ow. Dude. Help. Alright. Whatever. Huntress can't hit anything, so do that. Alright. Leave me alone, lady. She's dead. So many shots. That's always the problem here, right? He just eats way too many rounds. Like, he gets a good start. He's like, "Durr-durr, I'ma stand against a wall and get shot 80 times. So, 80 times, that's optimistic. It's not like 400. Hey, well, time to try again. That's what I was talking about there. If you turn to the inside a little bit with this AC, you can still just edge it out. But it takes too much energy to be reliable, and this is why I always went and fought her first. Because this stun is way too much to be able to even function as a distraction. Especially since Kaiser doesn't want to do anything. Good job, Kaiser. How's that aiming at a wall going? Just finish it already. Unless he goes and takes him out with his missiles instantly. Question. All right, Genius AI, let's try this again. I don't want to do the absolutely dumb thing. So, okay, there is one thing you can do here. Is he immediately targets? The closest thing. If you go here, there's oftentimes a chance that, if you just hang out in this corner, he'll just lock onto you and run into the corner endlessly while getting shot in the back. Alright, come on. Really now. Kaiser, you can at least keep him over there, but come on. What are we doing here? Making bricks look intelligent. He's gonna be coming around soon here. Trying so hard to get through the wall, he went through the terrain again. It's not an official one to catch, but... Come on, one of you. Thank you. Perfect. Got him. Alright, do your thing. Come on. No, you're gonna go after Huntress? Okay, cool. I'll just stand here and die. That's nice. Okay, so something weird. What I remember from the original was that they, like, if you were doing the, like, free matches that you could get out of the main menu, thank you. Awesome. You just grenade me then. So, if you're doing the free matches out of the main arena, or main menu, remember that the team members had a tendency to try and protect the leader sometimes. Hey, Kaiser, there's not even anyone in the direction that you're going. Anyway, he puts no effort into trying to be helpful. Like, he'll just attack, and that's it. Run off on the right guy before he kills my partner. Amazing. Sick of them locking on you. Or not. Don't magically get it across the wall and just go in your own way. Okay, cool. Oh, you're hanging out in the corner. Good job. Genius, what are you doing? What is this? Go! Oh my goodness, buddy. This is... there's not even a level that way. Hmm. Right at Firebrand, but he has the dumbest freaking AI in the game. At least when you're using him to help. Give him your back. Way to go, champ. I don't know. Yeah, just do it. We need to reset this. If I stand still, he won't see me. Before, I'll say it again, I hate Cypress so friggin' much. Dancing. Yeah, I don't really care if I take a little damage from her. I just want to be able to get her out of this fight. Actually, I know I'm shooting her in the shoe, but for sucking. What is going on? you finally fired when there's a wall between you two. I'm not actually as salty as I probably sound about this. It's just amazing. Like, AIs are AIs, but dude, what is Elonica? I want to know. Okay, fine. There. Good. You just redeemed yourself. Good job. And now we finish everything else. Alright, these two... Might as well just go ahead and test this with these two. Ions with a quiff. I'm gonna walk straight out of bounds. That is what I'm gonna do. That's the only real way to win, you know. Nobody has time for all this violence. You gotta leave. Gonna do the pacifist. Alright. Over here. Alright, now then. I'm gonna just go ahead and stand in the fun corner. What are you gonna do? Also, I'm gonna correct something real quick. Robot, though. Never actually checked if there's this type of animation for later games. Or even the ones beforehand. Gotta do the robot. What's gonna happen? I'm gonna figure it out, come over here and run out of bounds, what? Turns out, telling them to go out of bounds works better when I'm also going out of bounds myself. Oh well. Probably cut it here. Come back and do the rest in one bit. Take care of some stuff and whatnot. Alright, so, putting a quick break there.